everyone. Welcome to Emmanuel Christian Center Midweek Worship Service. God bless you. Thank you for joining us. If you're joining us in person, we are excited to have you. If you're joining us by Zoom or live stream, you are welcome. We're going to hear a great message from the Lord. Get your Bibles ready. Get your pens ready. You're going to want to write some things down. But most of all, you're going to want to share this with your friends and family. Hit that share button to send the gospel out so that it can go to those who need to hear it most, in the name of Jesus. We're going to start with 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 57. But thanks be to God, which giveth us victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. We are guaranteed victory through Jesus Christ. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you that you have guaranteed success in our lives. So we give you all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory that is due unto your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Welcome our pastor, Pastor Alvin Simpkins.
Well, God is good. Glad that you are tuned in tonight. God loves you. It's important that we worship the Lord. Raise your hands and let's pray together. Father, we thank you for your anointing, your blessing, your favor. Thank you for the Spirit of God. It's not by power nor by might, but it is by your Spirit. So we pray tonight for the Spirit of the living God to lead us and to guide us, stir it up, and take us to the next dimension. In Jesus' name, thank you, Lord, for all your help in every area of our lives. In Jesus' name I pray. Somebody say amen. Amen. Give the Lord a hand clap tonight as Elder William Harris come and lead us in prayer. Thank you, Lord.
Father God, we just thank you tonight for all that you are in our lives. We lift up our hands to you, Father God, on behalf of all of our children. Lord, we ask you now to touch them from the cradle to college, oh God. Bless them to let their lights shine in their schools, oh God. Let our children be on the honor roll as A students in their classes. Lord, prepare them to go to the next level in their life, oh Father. We pray, Lord, that they will be geniuses that will fulfill their purpose in life, that they will reach their destiny. For you, oh God, we pray that our children will be saved, sanctified, and full of the Holy Ghost and with power. Empower them, Lord. Endow them with your presence. Endow them with your Spirit. Endow them with joy and peace and love. This is our prayer in every one of them.
Yeah.
you are and just give the Lord a hand clap for his goodness and all of his mercy. It's time to go higher with the Lord, our Savior, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Take your Bible tonight. Go with me to 1 Peter. 1 Peter chapter number 5. 1 Peter chapter 5. So glad that you're tuned in tonight. God loves you. Everything is going to be all right. And you walk by faith, not by sight. God is a good God, and he loves you. 1 Peter chapter number 5 and verse number 8 and verse number 9. And he says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour, whom resist steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same affliction are accomplished in your brothers that are in the world. Thank you, Lord. Tonight my message is living with spiritual eyes and living with a sound mind, sound discretion, sound wisdom, living your life so that you make the best of every day. Raise your hands and let's pray about it. Father, thank you for the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Thank you for the Spirit of the living God. It's not by power nor by might, but it is by your Spirit. So Spirit of the living God, lead us and guide us. Holy Ghost, stir us up in every area of our lives. In Jesus' name I pray. Somebody say amen. Oh, bless you. You may be seated in the house of the Lord. God is on your side. Be sober, no stumbling through life. Keep your eyes open. Keep your eyes on the Lord and watch him work in your life. And we have to know, in the hour in which we live, we need to be sober in every area of our lives. People are losing their balance. They're losing their mind. They're losing their stability. And just know they're losing their peace. But God, Jesus said, I have come that they might have life and have it what? More abundantly. And so you have to know, God wants you to live the abundant life. He wants you to be happy. He wants you to be healthy. He wants you to be whole and not sad, depressed, down and out. Number one, there are five things, and there's four things in this verse that we want to talk about tonight. And that is, number one, be sober and be vigilant. The Bible says in 1 Peter 5 and 8, be sober and be vigilant. Be sober. Watch out for the uncommon, the unknown, the unpredictable, the unprepared, the undesirable, the unbelievable, the unspiritual, the unexpected in your life. Watch out for those things. They will mess you up. Watch out for the unusual. God want to bless your life. Watch out for the ungodly and the unacceptable. Be sober. Don't live your life in a state of frustration. Don't live your life in a state of being out of balance with society and with people. Live your life and be sober. Somebody say sober. Keep your head about you. Keep your mind about you. We walk by faith and not by what? Sight. And so you have to know, sober in the Bible means that we are we have a sound state of mind. That we have a sound state of mind. Do all you can to remain sober-minded in these last days. A clear head, solid thinking. Keep a level head. Somebody say a level head. Somebody put it on the screen. Keep a level head. Keep a level head about you. Stay alert. Hold your thinking together and just know that have solid thinking in your decision making. People are losing it in these last days, and they are losing it. Be temperate, be modest, moderate, and have a sound mind. Somebody say a sound mind. Don't live under the spirit of error. Don't live under the spirit of making one mistake after another mistake after another mistake, and do all that you can to stay wired, fired, and inspired. Stir it up. Somebody say, stir it up. Who wants to be around a sad, somber, dead person? Have some energy in your life. Have some passion about your life. Why? Because you are living with a sound, sober mind every single day. Salvation is not enough. You have to believe in Jesus' power, in Jesus' anointing, and in Jesus' blessings in your life to live a sober mind. Then the Bible says, be vigilant. In other words, be watchful. Be watchful. Be on guard. Watch what's happening in your life. Watch who comes in your life. Watch who go out of your life. And watch everybody around you. Somebody say, watch. Be mindful. Be ready. Not missing a beat. Just be watchful. Somebody say, watchful. Today, people are crazy. People are doing all kinds of things. When you're driving, you got to be vigilant. You got to be sober. You got to be watchful. You got to, because people are on their phone. They're getting your lane. I saw a truck the other day. It was all the way on the middle of the road. You know, and I'm thinking, how is this guy, an 18-wheeler driver, on an interstate, out of his lane? You have to know. You got to be vigilant. You got to be watchful. Don't be blindsided by things that can happen in your life. The Bible says, be sober. Be vigilant. Don't be blindsided. And we must do all that we can to keep our eyes on the prize. Pay attention in life. Somebody say, pay attention. Somebody say, pay attention. A lot of people are not paying attention, but there's a lot happening all around us here in the Maha City and all across this nation. You have to look with spiritual eyes and with natural eyes. You got to watch. Jesus said, watch. You have to watch. Don't take anything for granted. Keep careful watch for possible dangers or difficulties that could come into your life. You got on your job, you got to pay attention to your coworkers. You got to watch and be watchful. You got to be on the lookout. You got to pay. The Bible says in 1 Peter 5 and 8, be sober and be vigilant. These are the days where we got to pray and we got to watch and we got to be careful and we got to know where we're going. And we have to know that you have to keep your eyes open. Somebody say, keep your eyes open. And then pay attention. Somebody say, pay attention. Pay attention to everything around you. Be on alert. Be on your toes. Because these are the last days. These are the last days. And keep your eyes on Jesus. Don't do like Peter when he walked out on the water. As soon as he walked out on the water, there was a concrete of water there. And he started walking. But then he took his eyes. He took his eyes off Jesus. And he began to sink. And then he cried out, Lord, save me. You don't want that to happen to you. You want to keep your eyes on the Lord. Somebody say, keep your eyes on the Lord. Why do we want to be sober? Why do we want to be vigilant? Why do we want to be watchful? Why do we want to be attentive? Why? Because the second point is because your adversary, the devil, there's a demonic force that's been loosed in the lives of people today. And you have to know, the enemy, Jesus said, he comes in John 10:10, the thief cometh not but for to what? Steal and to what? Kill and to what? Destroy. He says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, never underestimate the power and the strategies of the enemy. He comes to destroy your life, mess up your money, mess up your family, mess up your career, mess up your marriage, mess up everything good in your life. You got to know how he works and fight back. Somebody say, fight back. You have to fight back. We have a spiritual enemy, and you have to know. You got to ask God for divine protection. Raise your hand with me wherever you are, online, stream on Zoom. Put your hand all the way up. Everybody say, Lord, thank you for divine protection. Come on, open your mouth and say, Lord, thank you for divine protection. In Jesus' name I pray. Praise the Lord for the victories that you have in your life every day. It's a victory to get up and tie your own shoes. That's a victory. That's a victory. It's a get up. It's a victory to get up every day and button your own shirt. That's a victory. Somebody say amen. Don't be afraid. Just be wise. Somebody say be wise. Your adversary uses bad decisions. He uses bad choices to destroy the people of God. Sometimes he just use your bad decisions that you made. Be sober, be vigilant. Your adversary, the devil, he does not want you happy. He does not want you joyful. He does not want you to praise the Lord. He does not want you to do anything for the kingdom of God. But you come too far. You come too far to be quiet. You come too far to not have a praise in your heart. The Lord's been good to you. Somebody say, I am blessed. Give no place to the devil. The Bible says give no place to the devil. No place to the devil. Why? Why? Number one, what are we going to do? Be sober. Be vigilant. Number two, because your adversary, the enemy. And then number three, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. You have to know the enemy is looking for you. He want to meet your head on. He wants you to know that he wants to destroy your life. But God is our source. Somebody say, the Lord is our source. You got to cover your life. Somebody say, cover your life. Cover your life. Pray up. Read the word. Give your tithes and offerings. Be helpful to people that need it. Love one another and have the sound decision. That's what messes people up. They get off into these crazy thinking patterns. They get off in these listening to John on the job, listening to Sally Mae on the job, listening to the atheists on the job, listening to all the other crazy people on the job. You don't need to hear what they got to say. Hear what the Bible says. Don't listen to people that have crazy ideas or conspiracy theories about everything. Don't listen to those people because they feed into the enemy's plan. And they're getting you to doubt in life. You have to have faith. Somebody say faith. You got to have faith going forward. You got to have faith. We live in the Mile High City in Colorado. You got to have faith to be here. If you're going to be in this city, you better have some faith. God is going to help you. Somebody say help. And so we have to know the enemy walks about looking for the uncovered, the unprotected, the unconnected, and those that are not unified. Let me say it again. The enemy walks about as a roaring lion, looking for those that are uncovered, unprotected, unconnected, and not unified. If you're out there all by yourself, the enemy is after you. The day of the Marlboro man or woman is over. We have to be a team. Together, everyone accomplishes more. Teamwork. Somebody said teamwork. Somebody said teamwork. If your family's going to make it, you got to be a team. Somebody say teamwork. Because the enemy is walking about seeking whom he may destroy. But you got to draw close to the Lord and he will draw close to you. Don't allow your life to just drift and be untested and be uncovered all alone. He's looking for those that are all alone, uncovered, unprotected, unconnected, not unified, and just untested all by themselves. Somebody say amen. That there comes a time when you got to stay in God's house. You got to get in his house and stay. And don't be blindsided by the enemy. And cover your life. Raise your hand. Let's pray with me. Everybody say with me. Say, Lord, I cover my life by the blood of Jesus. Say it again. Say, Lord, I cover my family by the blood of the Lamb. One more time. Say, Lord, I cover my finances by the blood of Jesus. He will attack you and he can attack you, but don't be destroyed. The Lord is on your side. Give your whole tithe. God says, I will rebuke the devourer from your life. I will rebuke the devourer for your sake. Malachi 3:11. God says, I'll rebuke the devourer. I'll run him off from your life. You don't have to live in a state of fear. You can live in faith, walk by faith, knowing that the Lord is going to take care of you. Walk by faith, knowing in these last days that God is on your side. Because Jesus said in John 10:10, the thief cometh not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But I have come that you might have what? Life. And have it more abundantly. The enemy take advantage of people's bad decisions. He take advantage of their bad decisions. And then he come in and wreak havoc in their life. You have to watch your thinking. Be sober. Be vigilant. Your adversary, the enemy, walks about as a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. But you come too far. Somebody say, I've come too far. Put it on the screen. You've come too far. The Lord is on your side. The Lord wants to help you. The Lord wants to protect you. That no matter what you're going through, the Lord is right there with you. Somebody say amen. Jeremiah 23:29 said his word is like a fire and a hammer. That's why whatever you're going through, you gotta lay some word on it. The Bible says in Jeremiah 23:29 that his word is like a fire and a hammer. Somebody say hammer time. When the enemy attack you, you just gotta say hammer time and fight back with the word of God. The grass wither, the flower fade, but the word will stand forever. Somebody say his word will stand forever. Get in the word and begin to declare over your life, the Lord is my help. Somebody just say help. And he says, I rebuke the devourer for your sake. I run him off. Tithing is never about money. Giving is never about money. It's about rebuking the devourer. It's about protection over your life and your family. It is about trusting in the Lord, knowing that he's able to take care of you and all that concerns you. Don't be fooled by the lies of the devil. Tithing is never about money. It's about God's trusting in you, that you have God's favor, and that you, God, want to protect you from the enemy. He says, I rebuke the devourer. If you bring the tithe, he said, I'll rebuke the devourer for your sake. I'll run him off from your life. You'll be amazed at how the enemy run families. You'll be amazed at how the enemy destroy families. But God is able. Somebody say, he is able. Now under him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. That's why you got to stir it up. Somebody say, stir it up. You got to stir it up. Somebody say, stir it up. That's why we sing. We stir it up. That's why we pray. We stir it up. That's why we shout to the Lord. We are stirring it up. That's why we call on the Lord. We are stirring up. That's why we ask God for help. We are stirring up. Raise your hands right where you are. And everybody say, Lord, I need your help. In Jesus' name I pray. Say it again. Say, Lord, I need your help. In Jesus' name I pray. We have to know we overcome him by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. You overcome the enemy. You overcome him. Revelation 12:11. You overcome him by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. That's why every day you ought to be calling on the blood. The blood. Every day the blood. Every day the blood. See, the enemy wants the church silent when it comes to the blood of Jesus. Because he knows that's one of our greatest weapons, the blood. God is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that you ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. It's not anything else. It's about what worketh in us. That's why you got to stir it up. Somebody say, stir it up. When the enemy attacks your life, you got to stir up God's anointing. You got to stir up his power. You're going through a challenge in your life. You're going through situations in your life. You're going through problems and concerns in your life. You're going through major discretional things in your life. You got to stir it up. Somebody say, stir it up. Now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh where? In us. Stir it up. Somebody say, stir it up. Raise your hand with me all on the live stream. Everybody say, Lord, I stir up your power in my life. In Jesus' name I pray. And all these things, the Bible says in Romans 8:37, we are more than conquerors. So don't get caught up into the traps, into the battle that the enemy has raised in your life. Just begin to declare the blood. Then you begin to declare the power of God is going to be stirred up. Then you begin to declare, I am more than a conqueror. Somebody say, I have favor. Say it again, I have favor. David said, I would have fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Psalms 27:13. That I'm going to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Raise your hand. Let's declare. I'm going to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Put your elbow all the way up and say, declare. I'm going to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Psalm 27:13. I'm going to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. The Lord is our help. Somebody say, the Lord is my help. Say it again. The Lord is my help. If they obey and serve him, they will spend their days in prosperity and their years in pleasures. Job 36:11. So yes, we're going to be sober and vigilant because the enemy, the adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, is walking about seeking whom he may devour. He's looking for somebody to devour. But we are going to obey Job 36:11. We're going to obey and serve him. And we'll spend our days in prosperity and our years in pleasure. Let's say it again. Job 36:11. Mark it in your Bible. If they obey and serve him, they will spend their days in what? Prosperity. And their years in what? Pleasure. See, all you have to do is serve the Lord. God will take care of you. I know rich people that got money, but they're sad. They're broke. They're broken in their heart. They're sad. Just because you have money doesn't mean that you can enjoy life. Most people with money, they are this sad and distressed. But you have to know, the Lord, when he blesses you because of your righteousness to him, then he said you'll spend your days in prosperity and your years in what? Pleasures. You'll spend your days in prosperity and your years in pleasures. And so you have to know, you have to embrace the blessings of the Lord. He said in Proverbs 10:22, the blessing of the Lord maketh rich and addeth no sorrow. You have nothing to fight about. You have nothing to be arguing about. You have nothing to be mad about. The Lord's been good to you. Is there anybody on live stream that know the Lord's been good to you? Is there anybody on Zoom that know the Lord's been good to you? Is there anybody in the house tonight that know the Lord's been good to me? Raise your hand and say, Lord, thank you for your help. Christians sometimes get the mentality, I'm going through. No, you're going through because you keep saying you're going through. You got to begin to declare that if I obey and serve the Lord, I'm going to spend my days in prosperity and my years in pleasure. Let the enemy roam. I am adopted into the family of God. I am adopted into the family of God. He is our Father. And David said, I've been young and I'm old, and I've never seen the righteous forsaken or the seed, what? Begging bread. Somebody say, I'm a child of God. Raise your hand on live stream and say it with me. Say, I am a child of the King. Come on, say it again. Say, I am a child of God. No matter what's going on in your life, God loves you. He has a plan for your life. And if bad things are happening in your life, we live in a fallen world. Bad things happen to good people. But you just got to keep your faith up. You got to pray every day. You got to stand on the word every day. The word is a fire and a hammer. It's a weapon against the enemy. And you got to begin to declare, the Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my help. The Lord is my shade on my right side. The sun shall not smite me by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord is my keeper. I am. Somebody help me say, I am. Blessed. In Jesus' name I pray. In Jesus' name I pray. And number four, I close with number four. Be sober. Be vigilant. Your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. May, underline that word, may devour. When you have the word in your life, he's not going to devour you. He's looking for those that are uncovered, unprotected, uncared for, unread, unprayerful. Those are the ones he's looking for. And then number four, whom resist steadfast in the faith. You got to resist him in the faith. You got to resist forces that come against your life. You just got to say, the blood of Jesus. You got to resist it. And you got to declare, the Lord is my help. You got to resist it. Somebody say, resist. Resist. Whom resist steadfast in the faith, standing on your faith, you're going to resist him and know that this too shall pass. Somebody say, this too shall pass. And keep your mind about you. The enemy today is after the mind of people. He's after people. That's the first place door he kicked is on your head. He's after your thinking. So every day I pray, Lord, keep my mind. I lay hands on my own head. I said, Lord, keep my mind. If you keep your head, you love the Lord with your heart, your soul, and with all of what? Your mind. He wants, people are losing their mind. Teenagers are losing their head. Young men are losing their head. We have to be sound and stable. Somebody say stable. Husband, you got to be stable. Wives, you got to be stable. Yes, if you have adversity, go on through the adversity, but maintain your stability. Maintain your sobriety. Maintain your vigilance that I'm going to be sound. Somebody say sound. Raise your hand with me and let's pray about it. Everybody on the screen. Everybody say, Lord, keep my mind. Say it again. Say, Lord, keep my mind. One more time. Say, Lord, keep my mind. In Jesus' name, I pray. Be sober. Be vigilant because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour, whom resist steadfast in the faith. When you resist him in the faith, do you know you stand by faith and God will help you? Jesus said to the man when he healed him, according to your faith, be it unto you. It's nobody else's faith. It's your faith. It's according to your faith, be it unto you. And the Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 11, lest Satan should get an advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his devices. And we know how to fight back. Somebody say, fight back. You got to fight with the word. You got to fight with prayer. You got to fight with stirring up the anointing that's upon your life. You got to fight with worship. Lord, I praise you. Lord, I bless you. Lord, I honor you. You got to fight back. Somebody say, fight back. Somebody say, fight back. Live your life with spiritual eyes. Spiritual eyes. Looking at things from the natural and the spiritual. And when we live our lives that way, we'll have favor and we'll be blessed. Somebody say, I am blessed. And then you have to break every curse. The enemy uses bad decisions, curses, old generational curses, to come into our lives. And he uses what you say. If you keep saying, I don't know if I'm ever going to get through this, then the enemy, you've given him the rope that he needs to hang your life. They said in the Old Testament, God brought us out here for us to die. And the Bible said the ears of the Lord heard that. And then the Lord said, as you have spoken it in my ears, so I'm going to do unto you. You got to begin to declare, I'm going to be all right. Somebody say, I'm going to be all right. Somebody say, I'm coming out. Somebody say, I have favor. You have to bind the strong man of negativity that the enemy uses in your life. Bad decisions, bad confession out of your mouth, uncovered, not giving anything to the work of the Lord. And then God said, I rebuke the devourer if you would support my kingdom here on earth. Don't get blindsided. Live with your eyes open. Live with spiritual eyes. Bind every strong force that come against your family. Give no place to the devil. And then you have to repent every day and say, Lord, I'm sorry. If I hurt anybody's feelings, I'm sorry. If I said an idle word, I'm sorry. If I did anything wrong, I'm sorry. You have to repent every day, and you got to pray every day. Somebody say, pray now. And speak life. Begin to declare, I'm going to be all right. Somebody say, I'm going to be all right. Everything's going to work out. Somebody say, it's going to work out. On your job, in your family, in your career, wherever it is, in your health, it's going to be all right. You just got to walk through the days of getting from bad health to good health. But it's going to be all right. And then you got to begin to speak life. Somebody say life. Enemy, use your negative words. Speak life. And then you got to invoke the power of the blood. Somebody say the blood. The blood. And every day, thank the Lord. For faith that matters. Thank the Lord for faith that makes a difference. Thank the Lord that you believe in God. There are people all around the world that believe in Buddha, Muhammad, Hare Krishna, you know, all these other crazy religions. You know, but the Bible says there's no other way but through Jesus Christ. He is the way. He is the way. Somebody say, He is the way. According to your faith, be it unto you. Stand by faith. Somebody say, faith. Faith is the evidence of things hoped for. And you have to know, you got to hope and believe for the best. That's why David said, goodness and mercy shall what? Follow me. So that you got to call in goodness. You got to call in mercy. Thank you that something good is going to happen to me tomorrow. Thank you that the Lord is on my side. Thank you that I have favor. Somebody say favor. Be sober. Be vigilant. Your adversary walketh about seeking whom he may devour. Be sober and declare the Lord is on my side. Somebody say the Lord is on my side. Raise your hand with me and say, Lord, thank you for being on my side. Say it again. Say, Lord, thank you for being on my side. I am blessed. Say it one more time. I am blessed. See, don't get blindsided. Don't be silent. Don't be fearful. Don't be lazy in your praise. Don't be a scatterbrain. Have a sober thinking, a sound mind. The enemy is losing. He's banking on you losing control. But you got to keep it all together. Somebody say, Lord, help me to keep it together. Lord, help me to keep it together. He's banking on you, but you got to stand on your feet. You got to begin to declare, the Lord is on my side. You got to begin to declare, I plead the blood. Somebody say, the blood. Somebody say, the blood. I plead the blood of Jesus over every area in my life. And everything's going to be all right. Somebody say, everything's going to be all right. I'm going to get through this. Whatever you're going through, you're going to get through it. God has a plan for your life. He has a plan for your future. He is on your side. This too shall pass, and everything is going to be all right. I will keep my fire burning. Somebody say, keep the fire burning. Keep the fire burning. Fire is the prayer in your life. I'm going to keep the fire burning because goodness and mercy is going to follow me all the days of my life. I'm going to keep the prayer wheels turning because the Lord is on my side. No weapon formed against you shall be able to prosper. Do you receive it tonight? No weapon. The weapons may be formed, but my Bible says they shall not prosper. The Lord is on your side. I'm talking to somebody's soul. The Lord is on your side. So you got to declare, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that's within me. I'm going to have blessings in the land of the living because the Lord is on my side. I am adopted into the family of God. I am God's child. I know everything. Somebody say, everything is going to be all right. And if you are alive tonight, and if you are still here, the Lord's been good to you. COVID has killed 700,000, but you are still standing. COVID has taken out moms. COVID has taken out dads. COVID has taken out sons. COVID has taken out daughters. COVID has taken out grandmothers. COVID has taken out grandfathers. But you are still here. Somebody ought to praise him. You are still here. Somebody say, I am still here. The Lord is on my side. The Lord is my help. The Lord is my strength. The Lord is my shade. The Lord is my favor. I have blessings on my life. The blessing of the Lord maketh rich, and he added no sorrow. You will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Spend your days in prosperity, your years in pleasure. Serve him all the days of your life. Worship him all the days of your life. Magnify him all the days of your life. Give him glory every day. Because David said in Psalm 124, if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, I would have never made it. So I joined David. If it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, I would have never made it. But I am still healed. I am still blessed. I have favor. If you have favor, put your hands together and just shout favor, 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 favor on your life. I will surround the righteous with favor as a shield. I am blessed. Somebody help me say, I am blessed. You can't be silent. The Lord's been good to you. You can't be quiet. The Lord has blessed your life. You can't close your lips. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together. The Lord's been good. Thank you for all your help. Somebody shout help. Somebody shout help. You are blessed. When you were sick, the Lord gave you healing. When you were in trouble, the Lord brought you out. When you were broke, the Lord gave you money. When you were friendless, the Lord lift you up to be a friend. You are, somebody say, I am adopted into the family of God. You gotta know who you are. And no weapon formed against me shall be able to prosper. No weapon formed against you shall be able to prosper. Somebody give him a praise. Somebody clap your hands. Somebody lift your hands. Oh, the Lord is our shield. I am blessed. When you were down, he picked you back up. Am I in the right church tonight? When you were down, the Lord picked you up. When you were discouraged, the Lord encouraged your life. When you were discouraged, the Lord encouraged your life. He helped you to get back to being wild, fired, and inspired. The Lord is our shield. The Lord is our rock. No weapon formed against you. No weapon formed against your children. No weapon formed against your life. You are blessed. Somebody help me say, I am blessed. Help me one more time. I am blessed. Help me one more time. I am blessed. If you receive it, give the Lord a hand clap. Oh, praise the Lord. Oh, praise the Lord. Give the Lord a hand clap. Oh, praise ye the Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Raise your hands all over the house. Raise your hands on live stream. Everybody say, Lord, I am blessed. Thank you. I am still here. Say it again. Say, I am still here. In the midst of it all, thank you for allowing me to live. Thank you for all your help. Stretch your hand all the way up. And everybody say, Lord, thank you for all your blessings. I receive your word tonight into my soul. Man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of the Lord. Raise your hands all over the house. Father, thank you for your word tonight. Thank you for all your help. We are children of the Most High God. We are adopted in to the family of God. So we know that you're going to pay every bill. We know that you're going to work out every problem. We know that you're going to bring us out of every situation. We know that you're going to bring us through every infirmity. We know that you're going to help us. The Lord is our shepherd. We are adopted in. Somebody say, I'm adopted in to the family of God. Know who you are. You're a child of the King. And no weapon formed against you shall be able to prosper. The Lord is on your side. Somebody say, he's on my side. Say it again, he's on my side. One more time, he's on my side. Oh, the Lord is on my side. And I am blessed. Stretch your elbow all the way up, wherever you are. And everybody clear, say, Lord, thank you for being on my side. I am adopted into the family of God. Thank you, Lord, for supernatural help in every area of my life. No weapon formed against us shall be able to prosper. The weapons may be formed, but they will not prosper. In Jesus' name I pray. Somebody say amen. For those of you who have loved ones that need this, need the Lord, raise your hands and let's pray for them. The Bible says in John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believe in him should not what? Perish, but have what? Everlasting life. Then he says in Acts 4:12, neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. But the name of Jesus. But the name of Jesus. The other religions don't call on Jesus. But we as Christians, we know that Jesus is Lord. He's the Son of the Most High God. And for those of you that have lost loved ones, raise your hand. Father, we pray for our lost loved ones. Just call out their names as you're praying for them. Lord, we just pray for our lost loved ones. In the name of Jesus, we just plead the blood of Jesus over them. May they spend eternity with you. Oh, God, we thank you that you will save their soul. Draw them near to you. Don't let them spend their life, their eternal life, on the wrong side of eternity. We plead the blood. Somebody shout, the blood out of your belly, from the depth of your soul. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. Cover our lost loved one. In Jesus' name we pray. Rebuke the devourer from their lives. Write their names in the Lamb's Book of Life. Thank you, Lord, for taking care of our loved ones. We know that you love them. In Jesus' name I pray. Somebody say amen. Oh, the Lord is good. You may be seated. Take your Bible and turn with me to Psalm 115. Psalm 115. Thank the Lord for his goodness. Your soul needs the word. Jesus said, man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Your soul needs the word. 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 The word of the living God. And then the Bible says in Psalm 115, verse number 12, the Lord has been mindful of us. He will bless us. He will bless the house of Israel. He will bless the house of Aaron. We are on his mind. Somebody say, I'm on God's mind. I'm on God's mind. He will bless them that fear the Lord, both small and great. Verse 13, verse 14 said, the Lord shall increase you more and more, you and your what? Children. The Lord shall increase you more and more. Pastor, how do I get the increase from the Lord in my life? The Bible said the Lord shall increase you. But how do I get the increase? You get the increase first by releasing to God seed. Releasing to God. Your release causes your increase. Your release to God causes your increase. And your seed that you sow puts a demand on the harvest. Harvest only respond to one thing, that is seed. You got to have seed in the ground. And watch what God will do in your life. When you have seed in the ground. When you have seed in your ground. When you hold back, you unleash the spirit of lack. When you hold back, you unleash the spirit of lack in your life. When you hold back, you unleash the spirit of lack. You'll lack this. You'll lack that. You'll lack this. But I have learned that when you release your seed, increase will come into your life. The Bible doesn't tell us how. Jesus gives us an idea in chapter 4, verse 26. Mark 4:26. He said, the kingdom of God is as if a man should cast seed into the ground and should sleep and rise night and day, and the seed should spring and grow up. He knoweth not how, because it's supernatural. You got to have supernatural help if you're going to live in this state. You got to have supernatural help if you're going to live in this city. You got to have supernatural help from God if you're going to make it here in the Mile High City. Why? Because the cost of living is through the roof. Houses are $500,000 starting. You got to have supernatural help. Supernatural help will change your life and bless you. And the Lord will add unto you. And he'll bless you. Why? Because you are a child of God first, and then you live by the covenant. And he says, I'll rebuke the devourer for your sake. Somebody say amen. So live by faith. Live by supernatural help. Every day say, Lord, I need your supernatural help. Stand up on your feet. Let me pray for you. Right where you are in your home, on your living room, in your dining room, wherever you are, in the den, stand up. Let me pray for you. You need supernatural help to make it in, up along these mountains here. We got to have, your job is only a seed. It's not enough. Your job is not enough. You need supernatural help. Somebody shout, help! Because you get a job, that's not enough. That's not enough to pay off all your bills. That's not enough for you to save up. That's not enough for you to have for investments. You got to have supernatural help. And when you give to God, he says that I'll give it back to you 1,000 times more. The 1,000-fold blessings, Deuteronomy 11:1. 1,000-fold blessings will come upon your life. Raise your hands to the Lord and let's pray together. Father, thank you for your people tonight. We declare no weapon formed against us. We are thankful that you are our help and our shield. We declare the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. So we call it in. Somebody say, call it in. We call it in from the north, from the south, from the east, from the west. We call it in. Wealth into our lives. The Lord shall increase you more and more, you and your children. The Lord will bless your life. The Lord will increase you more and more. We call it in. Father, bless your people. Those that give, bless the tithing. You said the blessing of the Lord maketh rich. Proverbs 10:22. Added no sorrow. Thank you for all your help in our lives tonight. We give into your kingdom and we thank you for all your help. In Jesus' mighty, matchless name, I pray. Somebody say amen. Say it again, amen. One more time, amen. The Lord is the key to your supernatural health. Not going to make it by yourself. Your job is not enough. I know you think you got a great job. That's not enough. You need supernatural help. And that supernatural help comes upon the people of God when they trust in the Lord with all their hearts and lean not unto their own understanding. Somebody say supernatural help. Say, I receive it. Raise your hand and say, Lord, I receive supernatural help in our lives today. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Somebody say amen. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, speak unto Aaron and his son, saying on this wise, you shall bless the children of Israel, saying unto them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance and smile on you. Turn his face towards you and shine upon you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give you peace. And they shall put my name upon the children of Israel. And I will bless them. We are children of God, adopted into the family. Somebody say, I'm a member of the family of God. Say it again, I'm a member of the family of God. Father, thank you for your word tonight. Thank you for the people of God who are members of the family of God. We are adopted in to God's family. So we receive your blessing tonight. Go with us, lead us and guide us. Bring us back on this same appointed hour. In Jesus' name I pray. Somebody say amen. Amen. God bless you. I'll see you on Sunday. The Lord say the same. God is a good God. Go in peace and serve the Lord.
the field. We're blessed when we come and when we go. We cast down every stronghold, sickness and poverty must cease, for the devil is defeated. We are blessed. Somebody say blessed. For the devil is defeated. We are blessed.